The Soybean School on RealAgriculture.com is brought to you by Pride Seeds, CruiserMax Vibrance Beans, and High Stick NT.
Here we are on a nice, what used should have been a nice summer day, now a rainy day, of course, right when we're ready to shoot. And what we're going to look at are some trials that OMAP has in conjunction with North Central Soybean Research Program. One of them is looking at soybean cyst nematode and development. One of the key things growers can do right now, we planted these soybeans about 4 to 5 weeks ago. It takes 30 days or so for the cyst to develop on the young roots. And now is a great time for growers to be out there and examine their roots, dig up those plants, and look for those beautiful white cysts that you'll see on the roots. And here, and always use the shovel, because you want to get the soil, you want to get the soil up with you, you want to knock that soil away. You never want to pull a plant out, because if you do so, you end up leaving a lot of the fine roots, such as here. You can see those fine little cysts on those roots. If you yank that plant out and then leave those roots behind, you'll often leave these fine roots behind, and therefore you'll get a misunderstanding or not a true representative sample or understanding of what's going on in the field. If you knock that soil away, what you should see are these beautiful pearl-like cysts. And of course the rain's coming now, but you see where my finger is. They start off as these fine, white, round, lemon-shaped cysts. They'll turn yellow, and then over time they'll turn brown. And basically it takes about a month to go from cyst to cyst. And if you knock those cysts off, this is a susceptible variety, and you can see just how much cysts are on those. You can also just take your fingernails to it and squeeze it, and you can see how the eggs are expelled from that cyst. And therefore, that's a good example of how you can test whether it's a cyst versus a sand grain or other things in there. So keep that in mind. Here's a comparison root on a resistant variety. You can see the susceptible variety here with all the cysts forming, same planting, same time frame, and here you can see a nice clean root system. Just because you've got a resistant variety doesn't mean though that you won't ever have any cyst on them. A resistant variety can still develop cysts on them as well, and that's also a warning sign as well. If you've got a resistant variety that's performed well and you start noticing more and more cysts on the roots, that could be an indication that the cyst nematode population in that field is adapting to that source of resistance and therefore being able to bypass it, and over time will develop to the point that that resistance source is no longer effective. So now's the time for growers to get out there, dig up their plants, look for these cysts on the roots. Gives you a good evaluation of how your variety is performing, but also gives you an opportunity to then soil sample, know what the population is, and again, plan for future.